recorded from the Coletta Crew Chief Lounge, where you never know who or what you're gonna find. It's Late Night Lounge with Buck and Janno. Tonight's guests barely need any introduction, as they're each more legendary than Buck and Janno combined. It's Al Segrini and Tom Prock. How'd they get them on the show? Plus many more shenanigans and surprises on Late Night Lounge with Buck and Janno.
Third episode here. We're in Sin City.
Are you drunk or what?
No, this is our opening. We're in Sin City. We got Tom Prock, Jimmy Prock's dad. I mean, everybody knows who Mr. Horsepower is. So Tom drove back in the forever, drove this custom body, Detroit Tiger, drove tons of cars, match racing. Al Segrini. Al drove the Black Magic. He drove Boston Shake, and he drove the Brute Car, which was his own team. So
you can't forget the Highland.
Please don't bring
Highland Bandit. Yeah, I remember that car.
Do you know how many people bring up that car, the Highland Bandit? I had no ride, no nothing. I had nothing. I was out of a ride. I had nothing to do. So this guy had an alcohol car from Virginia. And he says he buys all this nitro stuff. He wants to make it a nitro car. So I look at it, and I need a ride. I mean, you know, back in those days, we had a motor and I'd drive out. So he shows up. So I put this thing together.
This was a nitro car?
This was alcohol. I turned into a nitro. I had a Mustang body on it. I said, how fast has this thing been? He said, oh, it's been over 195, almost 200 miles. I said, oh, yeah, cool. First time I take this thing out, I do a burnout, and it shakes, and the rear wheel comes off.
Shook on the burnout.
And the rear wheel exits out. The axle goes out. This guy had the rear end butt welded. It was no sleeve, butt welded. I go, are you crazy, man? So we get this fixed real quick. We get this thing. I said, okay, get that fixed. Now, you know, I got to race it. I want to make some money. So now, I go to English Town with it. Good old English Town, my favorite place. I whistle it down through there, and she's whistling down. And I just go to put my hand up to get the chutes. And I'm like, roof comes down. right down on my lap, the cage, and the brake is hooked up. Dad, I can't get at the brake. I'm kicking it, trying to get the brake to get the chutes to come out. I finally got the thing stopped. I bring that thing back. I said, buddy, this car isn't for me. I can't believe how many times people bring up that name, the Highland. Why do you pick that car?
I actually got to see that car run when I was I was 7 or 8 years old.
I can tell you, I'll hear a funny story about his dad. God rest his soul. Great guy, funny, Nick Senior, funniest guy in the world. And if I didn't see it with my own eyes, I wouldn't believe it. You were probably too young. I don't know how old you were, but we were at a match race sometime, someplace down there in Maryland. And I'm watching him, and the bed, we had clutch coolers. His father is over there. He got the cover off the clutch can, and he's got the water hose in there. This is no shit. A cap on the bed. Filling it up with water, cooling it down. I said, what in the hell are you doing here? I'm just cooling it down.
Another quick funny one is, we go to English Town, New Jersey, with this beautiful custom body arrow, painted circus. The best. This is a huge page of art. So we're trying to qualify for the summit, national summit. So up to that, we were having a problem with knocking off exhaust valves. Well, when it did it, it would punch a hole in the piston, and the thing would diesel. It would suck all the oil up. It keeps, and you go, you hold the brake down there, it won't shut up, it's smoke everywhere, right? So I get some ashes, I whistle it up through there. Well, knocks the head off the valve again, and now I get the thing stopped. And you know, now she's, smoking. All of a sudden, the right side of the car is on fire. And the fire's coming, and there's no side windows, right? And the safety safari crew comes, and they're not smart enough to put the truck in front of the car. They're off to the side. So the guy puts the car up, and it's burning, right? Now the fire's coming in, my helmet's getting burned. I mean, I said, I had enough of this. They won't shut up. So I roll out of the car, and I roll on the ground. Well, the kid panics, he drops the body in the car. I'm laying on the ground. This is the car I went down the track.
Picking
up speed.
How about the time you won $1,000?
Well, that's a good one, too.
Him and Ronnie are racing, and there's an extra grand up for whatever it was.
It was a Dodger Glenn benefit race.
So anyway, he scams the grand, right? The next day we're sitting in the National Dragster comes, and here's Segrini holding $1,000 check.
See, Fred
couldn't read.
Fred, like a jockey, you're only as good as the horse you were riding.
Yeah.
So, a guy like Fred Castronova calls you from Utica, New York, and I live in Boston, and you're a good kid. I want you to come up and drive my car. That's just how he spoke, right? Italian, big Italian accent. Tom was leaving, and I said, yeah, I'll come up and drive. I said, yeah, I'll come up there. So I go and start driving that car. It was like, I mean, he was the baddest ass, match race car in the East Coast. You raced Tom Prock, you're going to be up for a race.
Yeah.
You got Jungle Jim Lieberman.
Remember Phil Roberts?
Yeah. You know, and he had these kind of guys.
Freddie was a funny guy. He, you know, anything you bought for the car was the best, you know. But everything had to be either anodized or polished, you know. So we kept blowing these fucking blowers off. And we went to Capitol Raceway, and Robert forgot the fuel pump.
And Robert McNeil?
No.
Okay.
We get to the Capitol, and we got no fuel pump. So I go over to Fox, and Fox digs in his toolbox.
Jim Fox.
Yeah, he gives me the silver pump. And we put it on. Car runs 625. Never ran that ever, right? So I'm thinking, holy Christ, it's got some gas here or something. It was 18 over or something on the pump. So I sent the pump to Pink, and I said, flow this. See what it is? He says, well, it's nothing but a worn out dash tree
pump. It was his junk pump, and it all ass.
Scorching the earth with it. So it blew three blowers off. The last one it blew off in Suffolk, right in the lights. So I got to go back home with it and tell him, what the f*** are you guys doing? And I says, it's not the blowers. I'm not buying no more of the blowers, right? So I go upstairs, because we lived in the shop, right? I go upstairs and I call Pink. And I said, Pink, whatever you do, call the shop right now. They're downstairs playing cards, and tell them you're interested in what the problem is, because he's going to quit buying these blowers. So, you know, he's playing cards with these guys, and the phone rings, and it's Ed Pink, right? And he's talking to him about his troubles with the blower and everything. He hangs up, and he tells all these card playing guys, he says, hey, see that? Nobody calls Ed, but Ed Pink called me. So, here comes, after he told him whatever he told him. You remember the cork cases?
No.
They weren't like balsa wood.
They looked like balsa wood. They're cork finished. Like they were like
army camouflage. Like.
Yeah. So, yeah.
What's an army?
Said that they were corked. Well, the UPS guy comes in, gives him the blower. You know,
it was a Dow coating.
Huh?
Dow coating.
Oh, very good.
Dow said it, as a matter of fact.
But anyway, he opens it up, and the guy, he could do anything he wanted with the UPS guy. You know, he'd throw him out or whatever. He looks at this blower, and he goes, oh, it's not polished. And he picks it up like a football. It throws it.
This is so different right now, the area you guys are in. It's so different. I mean, a typical week for us would be Tuesday night out at Long Island Raceway.
I've been there, yeah.
Right? Tuesday night there, Wednesday night at Englishtown, right? Thursday night at AFCO, Friday night at Maple Grove on Saturday night, Maple Grove. And then from Maple Grove, on Saturday night, you go to Montreal, Canada to run Sunday.
This was a blast. That was typical. The member Frank LeSueur.
Yeah.
He used to book us into all these races. Yeah. So one weekend, we got the schedule to go from Maple Grove to Naperville overnight. Okay, well.
That was up in Canada.
Yeah. Right. Okay, so this here, we all haul ass and leave. This decides to stop and take a shower and stay in. He gets there at the very last minute, and this Ron Brackett kind of running the deal. Place is packed, right? And so in they come, and we're pulling up to run. We're all in our staging lanes and everything. And he pulls in, and so the guy gets a attitude, and he goes,
I'm in line, though.
You two guys ain't going to run. Yeah. I decided you got here a little late, and he goes, oh, really? And so he gets into it with the guy, right? So he comes down to Bergen and me and everybody. And he says, let's get out of here, fuck this guy.
This is the place of
packed.
I mean, they're packed.
He's
so
Frenchman.
I said, the promoter, you know, I said, you're full of shit. I'm in line. I'm in the car. I'm ready to go. We pull out next. What's this? But he's, well, no, you're going to miss this run. He says, I might not let you run your other two runs either. You won't? I said, well, what if I take all these guys and we get the hell out of here? He says, they won't stick with you. I said, they won't. So I get back to the trailer. Come on in the trailer, all you guys. We all get in the trailer. I tell them, look, these guys are jacking us around. They don't want to get out of my way. We came overnight from Maple Grove. We're beat, right?
Yeah.
I said, look it.
No, they're beat. You're rested.
Yeah, I'm rested.
So anyway. And you showered. And you have a fresh shirt on, too.
They all smell like goats.
And he has a sweater on.
Oh, you bet your ass, yeah.
They all smell like
prep
goats.
School.
All you could smell was Old Spice.
Exactly. Yeah.
So he goes, I said, you know, we got to sit together. Listen, let's get out of here. I'll get everybody's money from LeSueur. He will pay us, otherwise we'll dump his ass. He won't promote no more. Yeah. We'll get our money. Okay. Look like Vietnam, the doors dropping, boom, 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 the chaparrals, everybody's taking it, loading the car. People are, hey, man, where are you people going? We're out of here, man. We all hook up the trig, and we start pulling out the gate. Oh, man, they started stoning the tower. They're going to kill this guy. It was going to cause a riot.
And all he had left was two jets.
Yeah,
right?
That's it.
Gusted, and one of them blew up.
So we go to that. So that went on there, and, you know, naturally, I'm the instigator. So Frank LeSueur says, what did you do? So I said, what happened? I'm like, we're tired of getting jacked around, man. We're sticking together.
Yeah.
So now we go to ATCO. During the week, so we pull up back.
Jack Rizal.
Yeah. So you guys didn't run at all at that race?
No, we didn't run. We all left.
That
made
was
one run.
Awesome.
They made one run. I didn't get the run.
It was a riot.
It was almost a riot. These people were pissed. They were throwing stone in the tower and everything. So
they were throwing rocks at the trailers, too.
We get to ATCO. So first they were pulling the ATCO. And his ATCO Jack. We had the little shack came in. And I come rolling in with the black ratchet guy, right?
ATCO Jack, he was kind of a mean guy.
Yeah. So I roll the window down, and he goes, now, we ain't gonna have any trouble here, are we, today?